And finally, fresh off their successful Los Angeles concert, Pinoy pop girl group Beanie is now in Canada for their very first four-city Canadian tour. Their first stop on their Beanieverse live concert is in Vancouver. Beanie Joanna says they're grateful that their LA show was a success. They now look forward to performing for their fans in Canada.
It was overwhelming po dahil yung amount ng love na natanggap namin, parang we didn't expect that. But we had great time in LA and it's sad lang na we had to leave so soon. But however, we are so excited po to be here, lalo na it's our first time here in Canada and finally mamimitin namin yung Canada Blooms.
The highly anticipated Beanieverse live concert on Friday in Vancouver is already sold out. ABS-CBN's top homegrown talents fly next to Edmonton, followed by stops in Winnipeg and Toronto.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the rundown.
The United Nations seeing a rising threat by the Islamic State's Afghanistan branch in the wake of the cancellation of Taylor Swift's concerts in Vienna. The UN Counterterrorism Office says ISIL-K poses the greatest external terrorist threat to Europe. The group claimed a March attack on a concert hall in Moscow, leaving 145 people dead. One of the suspects in the foiled attack in Vienna also pledged allegiance to the Islamic State. Authorities, though, have yet to establish his links to ISIL-K.
ISIL-K has improved its financial and logistical capabilities in the past 6 months, including by tapping into Afghan and Central Asian diasporas for support. The group has also intensified its recruitment efforts.
Despite the cancellation, Swifties still gathered in Vienna holding a concert of their own and exchanging friendship bracelets. Some fans who flew halfway across the world to witness the Eras Tour were disappointed by the news. But if there's one thing they learned from the pop star, that is to shake it off and look on the bright side.
I mean, even if they try to destroy our Taylor Swift spirit, they really can't. And yeah, it's nice that people do this to show that you cannot just walk all over us.
So we're very upset, very disappointed, but we're just really happy that everyone's safe. And obviously, I mean, this is amazing. This is really heartwarming and lovely. So we're trying to look at the bright side.
Taylor Swift will return to London next week for the second leg of her shows at the Wembley Stadium. Fans say they were left panicked and scared for their shows after hearing news of the planned attack in Vienna. But UK officials say there's no indication the terror threats in Vienna will have any impact on their upcoming shows on London.
I've been to the concert already. Like, I couldn't imagine if someone, it's their first Taylor concert. It must have been, like, devastating. But at the same time, like, I'm so glad they found out, like, before everything had happened. So, like if Ariana situation doesn't happen again, because obviously no one wants to go to a concert with, like, risk of losing their lives.
For sure, yeah. Last night I was panicking a little bit. We did consider selling our tickets, but I think we took a few hours, we calmed down, we saw what the statements were that were being put out, and I think we're now feeling good about going again.
American network ABC confirms the debate between Republican candidate Donald Trump and Democratic rival Kamala Harris will push through on September 10. Trump had previously suggested he might back out of the debate, which has scheduled before Harris replaced U.S. President Joe Biden as the Democratic presidential candidate. In a news conference at his Florida residence, Trump said he also wanted two additional debates for the same month.
I think it's very important to have debates, and we've agreed with Fox on a date of September 4th. We've agreed with NBC, fairly full agreement subject to them, on September 10th, and we've agreed with ABC on September 25th. So we have those three dates, and those networks, they're very anxiously awaiting that date and those dates. So we have September 4th, September 10th, and September 25th. We have spoken to the heads of the network, and it's all been confirmed.
Well, I'm glad that he's finally agreed to a debate on September 10th. I'm looking forward to it, and hope he shows up.
Harris's rapid rise has sent Trump's team scrambling to recalibrate their strategy and messaging. Opinion polls show Harris has erased the lead Trump had built over Biden, and Democrats have ranked in hundreds of millions of dollars from voters and big donors in a matter of weeks. Earlier on Thursday, Harris and her running mate, Michigan Governor Tim Walz, met with auto workers in Michigan. This following the endorsement of their candidacy by the United Auto Workers Union. The Harris campaign is pushing to mobilize blue-collar workers in key battleground states.
We know the unions go to the middle class. The rest of America has to. Yeah. You know who doesn't believe that? Donald Trump. Yeah. He sees the world entirely differently. And it really starts with this. When I look at community and neighbors and unions, and the word that Sean said, unity, this guy doesn't know the first thing about unity or service. He's too busy serving himself.
We believe in the collective. We're not falling for these folks who are trying to divide us, trying to separate us, trying to pull us apart. That's not where the strength lies.
As a lifelong supporter of the union labor, for Tim and I to have the endorsement of the UAW.
The Harris campaign canceled events in North Carolina and Georgia, where remnants of Tropical Storm Debbie are bringing heavy rains and dangerous flooding. The Democrats will head to Arizona and Nevada later this week, visiting two more swing states likely to play a key role in the November 5 election.